My name is Kevin Pires. I'm a senior applications engineer with EXFO. And today, I'm going to do a quick little did you know it, talking about Optimode within iOLM. So Optimode is a configuration that we allow you to do with an iOLM. There's a paid aspect to it, then there's a free aspect to it. I'll talk mostly about the free versions of Optimode. And basically what Optimode is, it allows us to create configurations, iOLM configurations, that have algorithms that are optimized for specific type of testing. So if you're doing fiber to the antenna, so close events, very short link. If you're doing, say, fiber to the home, F2 PON, so 2.5 kilometers or less. If you're doing kind of metro transport, up to 20 kilometers, we allow you to create or use these custom Optimode configurations to optimize the testing and the test time. And so with a standard iOLM test with two wavelengths, it's about 90 seconds because it's a very comprehensive test. It does a deep dive into the fiber, multiple acquisitions, multiple pulse widths for any scenario, and then it gives you great results. But if you can optimize that a little bit more, so if you are only testing 2.5 kilometers, then we have an Optimode that'll bring that test time considerably, you know, down to 10 seconds or 20 seconds, depending on the number of wavelengths that you're testing on some of the test. Up to 20 kilometers, now it's 30 seconds. So instead of 90 seconds for two wavelengths, it's 30 seconds for two wavelengths, which is an incredible amount of time saving. And with these higher count cables, 864, 1728s, that is considerable return on your investment for this great tool. So let me jump into it. So I am on, so let me switch my cameras here, my famous cameras here. So basically, I have a FTBX 730C. So Optimode is a configuration that we have on many of our newer, well, on all of our newer test sets, but not all of our test sets. And so that's something that you need to understand. And so the spec sheet that we have on EXFO.com, and I'll put a link to the spec sheet, will detail which modules have which options, right? Which modules have which options. So the 730C that I have within my FTB1 Pro does support Optimode. If you have a newer EXFO OTDR and you do not see Optimode, you need to update the units because some of these functionality just came out within the last 6 months for some, and then within the last year or two for others. And so update to the latest version, go to EXFO.com, you know, to get your download and update your units. And so I'm gonna go ahead and just go straight into iOLM. So I already have it running in the background here. So here's iOLM. I'm gonna go over here to the right to test configuration. And again, I'm not gonna go through the entire configuration. We can do a lot with configurations, particularly with specific options, right? I'm gonna jump straight into test configurations here, over here to the right. And then from here, I have default set, which is what we typically have when it comes straight from the factory. So the default setting, this is that very comprehensive test that we have, right? So here's what I do. I wanna create a test specific to what I want to do. There's some pre-canned tests that are already in here that you could use, but if you wanted to create your own, you certainly can. So normally what I do is I go to default setting and I will duplicate it down here. So I'll duplicate it and I'll give it a name. I'm gonna give this one a name. I'll call it PON F2 short. Whatever you wanna name it, whatever makes the most sense to you, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and give it that name. And then now we see it right here. I'm gonna go ahead and modify this. And then within the first tab here under properties, we see Optimode. Now I'm gonna have some extra Optimode options in here that are part of our iAdvanced software suite. But the first few I'm gonna show you right now are free as long as your unit is updated and it's one of our newer units. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the drop down here. And then you'll notice there's several here. So the ones that come with the free version of the Optimode configuration is short link close events. And this is designed to do a really comprehensive test using very short pulse width at longer averaging time to make sure that it sees all the events, even if they're closely spaced. It does take a little bit longer, but that's what it's designed to do. And then we have fast short link, This is one of our newer configurations. So depending on the model of O2DR you have and the dynamic range or the power level, output capabilities of it, anywhere from 2.5 kilometers to 10 kilometers. For most of you on here, it's gonna be 2.5 kilometers, to about 5 or so, depending on the unit that you have. So we have that. And then we have fast medium range, which is up to 20 kilometers. In fact, it can go a little bit over that, it just takes longer. And so that one allows us to optimize for, say, a C-RAN deployment, which is typically 20 kilometers and less, or a standard metro transport system is usually 20 kilometers or less. So these three here are the free versions that come with it. These last two, I won't spend a lot of time talking about it. These come with our paid version called iAdvanced, PON last mile certification, and SFP safe troubleshooting. I'm not gonna talk about those here today very much, but those come with our iAdvanced software. And so I'm gonna jump straight into this. I'm gonna go ahead and say, I wanna do fast short link. Right, I'm gonna do a fast short link. I go in here to pass-fail thresholds and I would set all the thresholds that I need. I cover that in my iOLM training. I'm just gonna stick with fast short link. I'm gonna use the default pass-fails just for this quick little video. And now you notice I have pawn F2 short and you see fast short link. See it right in here. I'm gonna go ahead and close this out. And so now you notice down here in the very bottom left, that's what I have selected. And so I have a 3,000 foot launch cable. In fact, I'm gonna change this, go to user preference. I'm gonna change this to kilometers because that's the phrasing I was using today. And if the link is too long, it'll tell us. If the link is too long, it's gonna tell us here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and start iOLM. I'm not gonna do any naming conventions or anything like that because that's in my iOLM configuration. But you notice I'm running a test here. And look at the status bar down at the bottom right and how quick it is. So for those of you that have used iOLM in the past, this is lightning fast, lightning fast. And so for those high count fibers, especially from the splitter back to the terminal and a PON system, this really speeds up your testing. And so here are all my results. All right, so as quick as that. That was fast short link. And of course, if I wanted to create one for medium short link, I could do the same thing, and that's up to 20 kilometers. And so that's basically what I'm going to show you is that we have some new functionality that is free. Just update your unit and, you know, go to the EXFO site and, you know, look at our spec sheet. So, and I'll post a link to the spec sheet and it'll tell you which modules support, you know, some of this functionality and how far they can test and stuff like that. So it's a pretty comprehensive spec sheet here. But, you know, try to take advantage of that because it really is a great feature. And that's what I wanted to talk about today. So again, my name is Kevin Pires with EXFO. Thank you very much.